So the parenchyma, or the physiologically active portion of the tissue that comprises the kidney, is divided into the cortex and the medulla. The cortex is the tissue which surrounds the medulla, and oftentimes on gross specimens, it's difficult to discern what is cortex from what is medulla. So the medulla is organized into what we call pyramids, and they appear a little darker on this specimen, thankfully. So we can see a couple of renal pyramids there. And the cortex surrounds the pyramids on various sides. So for instance, the portions of the cortex that come between the bases of the pyramids and the renal capsule are known as the cortical arches. And the portions of the cortex that interleave between the pyramids are known as the renal columns. So, columns and arches are the two portions of the cortex. And we'll see that nephrons exist between the cortex and the medulla, in both the arches and the columns. So more of the renal corpuscles and proximal and distal convoluted tubules will be found in the cortex, whereas more of the nephron loops and collecting ducts will be found within the medulla. So those collecting ducts are going to coalesce into regions called the renal papillae, and it's at the papilla that we no longer have any of those physiological exchanges of materials between paratubular capillaries and nephron tubes. And so what is filtrate is now urine at the level of the renal papilla. And all of the papilla are the papillae. So those papillae are going to be surrounded by the minor renal calyces. And the minor renal calyces coalesce into major calyces. Major calyces coalesce into the renal pelvis, which is then contiguous with the ureter. Now, if these calyces are going to be found in the renal sinus, so all of those conductive parts are within the space, that concavity of the kidney surrounds. And within that space, we're also going to find healthy amounts or copious amounts of perirenal fat. So perirenal fat or adipose tissue will be everything within the renal fascia. And that renal fascia is going to surround the kidney, the suprarenal glands, the ureters, and all of that pararenal fat. Thank you very much for your time.